Hello, this is our nuclear medicine team. And this is Stobhill Ambulatory Care Hospital in the northeast of Glasgow where we all work. Stobhill Nuclear Medicine is the only department in Greater Glasgow and Clyde to undertake blood volume studies, a service which we also provide to neighbouring health boards. The blood volume study is an important diagnostic tool and combines both the use of iodine-labelled plasma and chromium-labelled red cells to investigate and aid characterisation of polycythemia. Unfortunately, in 2018, G announced that it would cease production of chromium, and with no other source available, it looked like Stobhill would be unable to continue with the blood volume service. However, our nuclear medicine team believed the blood volume investigation was a great asset to our service, and we were not prepared to lose this. Therefore, we started to look for alternative red cell labels. With its successful adoption in GFR studies, technetium was put forward as an alternative. But our team had some initial reservations, and our literature identified indium as a second possible alternative. After considering lots of factors, on balance, we believed indium proved to be the better fit operationally for our department. Before being able to draft a new protocol for indium, we undertook a number of pre-clinical checks in our cell labelling lab. One of the first checks was to assess the stability of the indium red cell label over time. We even devised a bespoke in-house red cell incubator as shown. Our pre-clinical checks demonstrated that indium label remained stable over a 60-minute period and that we were also able to successfully assay the red cell samples. As a result, we were able to set out a new dual isotope blood volume protocol using indium red cell label. We really hope you agree our team worked really hard in order to identify indium as a new red cell label and produce a protocol which in turn has ensured the blood volume service continues. And since May 2019, the use of indium has enabled nuclear medicine to continue to support the diagnosis of polycythemia in more than 70 patients. We also believe this work shows the nuclear medicine service is invested in all clinical investigations, not just high volume work. And finally, our highly trained staff have retained complex skills which can now be cascaded to future staff.